Hello everyone, welcome to this new video. We will learn the concept of creating simple study area map using QGIS. So let's start and please subscribe. First of all, let's understand the final map. This map contains three set of map with different level administrative boundary. In the first map, project district is highlighted in the map of country. In the second map, all the municipalities of Kaski district are shown along with the boundary of neighboring district of Kaski. In the third map, lakes and major road of Pokhara metropolitan city along with the boundary of neighboring municipality of Pokhara are shown. North arrow, graphical scale, legend box, title of map, nameplate and logo of organization are other element of map. This highlighted portion is footprint of third map. This element may not be important in this project but will be useful when generating multiple maps from single project. Now let's talk about dataset. I have downloaded the map of municipality inside Nepal from website of Survey Department. Link is in the description. District map was created by using dissolve function. I have selected the district around Kaski district and exported selected feature as district around shape file. Similarly, selected the municipalities of Kaski district to make Kaski local and selected the municipality around Pokhara to create local level around shape file. I have digitized the lakes and roads from Google Map. You can refer my previous video to learn about feature digitization on QGIS. Now, open new project and save the project. Now I will add those shape files. I will not explain more about symbology and level style in this video because the next video will be in this topic. Now I will create a print layout, say print 1. Okay. First of all, let's check the page property by right click on the paper. These are page properties. Now let's draw a rectangle as a border of page. Let's add three maps in page. 1, 2, 3. Now let's create first map. Go to main canvas and off all the layers and change symbology of district. We fill red color in Kaski district and make other districts transparent using rule based symbology. Okay, this is good. Now we go to layout, select map 1 and update map preview. This map is ready, so we can lock the layers. Now you can add or remove the layers, but print layout will not be changed. But when you unlock the layers, the preview will be changed. Creating and locking method will be difficult if you have to edit the map layers in future. So I recommend you to make map theme and use it. So let's create map theme for first map. On the layers, which should be displayed in map 1, click here. Add theme, give name Kaski in Nepal. Okay. Now we go to layout and update preview and select and follow map theme and select the theme. Okay. Now we make map 2. On these two layers, Kaski local and district around, I will make the district around layer transparent and make border thicker and display name in red color. For Kaski local, let's display name and decrease the text size. Use categorized symbology and edit some color to make the map bright. Again, go to map layout, update map preview and click on set map extent to match main canvas extent. Now let's add theme. at them. Local in Kaski. Go here, follow the map theme, local in Kaski. Okay. Now again go to main canvas and create main map. Of this, I'll make municipality boundary thicker and area transparent. Display names in green color. Display name of road in blue and smaller font. Display highway by thicker line and feeder road by thinner line using rule based symbology. I will give blue fill in lakes and display name in smaller fonts. I will fill light color in Pokhara metropolitan city. Go to manage map theme, add theme, lakes in Pokhara. Okay. Follow map theme, lakes in Pokhara. Let's zoom higher. Change the scale. Let's put frame on all three maps. Now I will add text here. Give title. Change fonts. Align center and middle. You can change the font size by scrolling over this icon. Okay. Similarly, add text box inside map 1 and map 2. I add another text box to make nameplate. Now for logo, add picture and select the logo from computer and select placement style. Add north arrow. Add scale bar. You can change the properties of scale bar from here. Add another scale bar in this map also and change the properties. Now I will make the footprint of map 1 over map 2. Select map 2, go to overview, add overview, select the map frame. You can change the frame style from here. I will make the border dash line. Now let's add a legend. I'll not keep all these items, so I'll give title. off the auto update and start modifying. First remove this road, double click here and give description. This is highway, so highway will be displayed. Double click here, type feeder road back, Lex is okay. Now remove all other item, click here, remove. So this is a map of lake, so I will push this lake at top. For this you have to click here. Okay, now move it to an appropriate location. Now the map is ready. You can export it as image or PDF from here. I will export as image. And final map looks like this. So this is all about print layout in QGIS. Please subscribe my channel. Feel comfortable to share your QGIS print layout experience in comment section. Thank you for watching. Goodbye.